guarantee I have is that they will crush in the presence of God. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Today, the God of turnaround will show himself for you. Only you can do what no man can do.
What no man can change you over me.
Only you can do.
Yeah.
What no man can do over me.
Only you can do. Hey, what no man can do. Jehovah me.
Only you can do.
Hey.
What no man can do. Jehovah.
Only you can say, Daddy. Only you can say, Jehovah.
Only you can do.
What no man.
Oh, what no man.
Just like you walk the streets of Galilee, and like you hear the saying, and you raise
the dead,
like you say, Lazarus, come forth, come forth. You are doing the same today.
You are doing the same today.
He is almighty. If you are saying amen, say better amen. That word is for somebody. Oh. God will show to you he is almighty. Father, I thank you. When you stretch your hand, no one can turn it back. Everything that needs a turning today, no one of them shall escape. In the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever has humiliated anyone, made a mockery of anyone, today I stand on the authority of your word and I decree they shall be overturned. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. So shall it be. Let the redeemer of the Lord say so. Congratulations. Please get seated. God bless you. Your prophets and your desire turn around. If you can understand this message, you will never be on the same spot again. God said, I will give you pastors after my own heart that will feed you with knowledge and understanding to this end that thou might be established. I want you to know this today. There is a prophet sent to you. But it requires your discovery. When you are profitless, you are profitless. When you are profitless, you are wingless. You can't soar into your desired place in destiny. I heard Bishop Abue say this. Your heavenly father gives you a place in heaven, but your spiritual father gives you a place here on the earth. Lack of understanding, much more spiritual understanding, can make you make a mockery of this, but you mock your own destiny. Many destinies have been stranded, relegated, and frustrated because of spiritual stupidity. When you know who is sent to you, it is your choice to believe. No pastor, no teacher, no apostle, no prophet goes about campaigning, believe in me, oh, so that I shall be well with you. It's your choice. Let me give you one testimony so that you understand what I'm saying. When late Archbishop Benson Idahosa was still around, something happened. God sent Bishop David Oyedepo, meet my servant. There is something he will impart to you. When Papa heard that word from the Lord, at first, his spirit reacted. How can I go to this man upon all the things I've heard about him? God asked him a question. Do you know him more than me? Do you know him more than me? Newspaper can publish. Men can speak against. But there is one that knows him. Do you know him more than me? He gathered himself. He now got his number. God said, I should come and see you. He said, God equally told me that you are coming. Did you get that? God told me what? That you are coming. And after that encounter, there was what we call a spiritual transference. A spiritual impartation. A spiritual duplication. And since then, the bond has been intact till today. Till today as I talk with you. Papa cannot disconnect from that family, because your prophet is your spiritual root, and your spiritual root determines your natural fruits. I was privileged to be in Living Faith Church Benin Sapele Road when Papa sent a message, go buy so so and so. Take it to the family. Bought cow, bought the turkey we buy, man. If you see that turkey now, turkey. Turkey day, turkey day. We entered. Say we are from Living Faith. Say, yeah, Papa said you are coming. We entered, dropped it in. Not one, not two, not twice. If you are profitless, you will be profitless. Your prophet determines, please regulate this mic, your seasons of change of blessings. Your prophet determines your faces of open heaven. Your prophets determine your speed. Your prophets also determine the flow of oil on your head. If your head is dry, you have disconnected. They will not look for you. You are to look for them. They will not campaign for your acceptance. You will desire what they carry. I remember one incident Papa went to see him. He said, others, when they come to show me what they have. They come to collect. But when you come to bless. He said, knee down here. I impart upon you the gift of on time. Whatever you need, before the need arise, the supply will be on ground. Who know like that kind of blessing? Another time he said, what I've not been able to do, you will surpass it. Has Papa surpassed it? So the solution to your poverty, to your frustration, to your hardship, is in the mouth of your prophet. Who you meet and receive determine what you receive. Even though you are designed for unlimited progress, unlimited change of level, there are things that are out to stop you, to limit you, to hinder you, to stagnate you, but not when there is a prophet around you. Not when there is a covering over your head. Thank God we are in the age and era where everybody now speaks in tongues. You speak in tongues, I speak in tongues. You ordain, I'm ordained. You prophesy, I can prophesy. But let me say this. Even in the witchcraft world, there is spiritual hierarchy. Please, off that phone. If you came to be blessed, off that phone. Let me say this. There is order in the realm of the spirit. Now let me just recap. Remember, two Fridays ago, we gathered to thank God how he delivered Bishop David Oyedepo. How many of us were aware? Good. Now let me share what really happened. Some days before the event, God's servant Paenoch Adegboye had a word from the Lord. What is the living doing among the dead? He said, Lord, what are you talking about? Go and pray for my servant, David Oyedepo. Without any phone call, he drove. He didn't even tell his wife. A fire landed. Before they will finish covenant hour prayer, he was already in the house. Entered everywhere, anointing every place. Enter kitchen, enter bedroom, enter parlor, enter study room, anointed every place. But now let me ask you a question. Is Papa not a prophet? Why couldn't he see it? Why couldn't he see it? Now, you can be a prophet. You can speak in tongue. You can be ordained, but there are some things you can't see. But if you have a cover, if there is a prophetic connection, when the enemy has planned to damage you, God intervenes for you. That's exactly what happened. After he anointed, prayed for him, prayed for everybody, and left. To let you, that jet is not a tokumbo. It's a tear rubber. They got around the Mediterranean, something, as you see, one of the control switch just detached. So, The pilot couldn't power the thing up again. The thing began to go down and down. What he did, handed over to the assistant pilot, went to the cabin of the engine, pulled out something, now came back and powered it. It was God's wisdom. That thing was an attack from the pit of hell. It's not a Molue craft, Lagos Oshodi, Lagos Oshodi. No! It was an attack from the pit of hell. But because an intervention has taken place, the arrow was diverted. May you not be prophetless. There are some things you can't see. That's why you must value the oil covering you. If not, you are in trouble. There are some things you can't see. Get that one clear now. What will have happened if you are disconnected from him? Everybody is looking for cover. What would have happened if you had disconnected from him? Because God can only intervene for you who you believe, not who you mock, not who you doubt. The reason why many are in church under the influence of heavy anointing and still stranded, disconnection. Or disconnected. And when you are disconnected, Satan is waiting for you. Every change of face in our life, including me, is tied to a prophet. It's tied to a prophet. That's why the people I call my mentors, I know who also is their mentors. I know also who is their fathers. I know who they submit to. Any person that says that cannot make a reference to somebody, fear that person. He doesn't have any spiritual father. He's a father on his own. He's Melchizedek. He just came. Are you around saying that? It's Melchizedek, he just what? Came. What prophets do, they confer upon you divine authority for turnarounds in your life. When they speak into your life, things must hear, doors must open. Soon as they hear of me, they shall submit themselves unto me. Believe the Lord our God, and thou shalt be established. Believe also his prophet, so shalt thou prosper. So your prosperity is tied to your prophet, not your prayer. How many prayer if he pray? Do you know the witches that are after you from your village and as well that you will not prosper? I just remember one young man now. He's an engineer, electrical engineer, current certified. Nothing to show. In fact, if you see him, you will call him a conductor. One day he came and met me. He came to my house. He brought a bunch of plantain. I asked him, what do you do? He says, sir, I'm an electrical engineer. I'm a current engineer. I said, what's your name? He said, my name is Engineer Igbodo. I said, where do you work? He says, sir, I just brought this seed so that God can change my life. I don't have any job. You don't have any job? The first thing that came out from my mouth, do you believe in me? Do you know what he said? You appeared in my dream. I said, come inside. I prayed for him. His testimony is too strange. I prayed for him. He got an electrical job. You know, electrical job is in level. It's not an electrical job of 5,000 that he will finish and be drinking a mama, eating mama put. He got an electrical job. From that electrical job, he was able to build a duplex. One in Lagos and one in Delta. Someone that didn't have money before was able to sponsor the daughters to Covenant University. I hope you know Covenant University, no be moi moi. He says, sir, things have changed. I say, I can see things have really changed. Now, while he was still doing that job, he got another one in Port Harcourt. So he was shuttling between two different sites. I said, Igodo, God has changed your story. You can never go down again. Just remain faithful. People that are connected prophetically, they change levels. They change levels. Time will fail me to talk about my masters. I talk about Ibiomi. I talk about Polenenche. I talk about Pastor Jeme. Why? Because I am connected to their grace. Because they too, they are connected to our fathers. Ibiomi is not a struggler. He's riding on prophetic wings and things are working. Polenenche is not a struggler. There are many churches in Abuja, but you can't deny his effect. Hear me? Define your spiritual roots. You have suffered enough. In Ezra chapter 4, we read the last verse. Ezra chapter 4, verse 24. We take it from there. Then ceased the work of the house of God, which is at Jerusalem. So it ceased unto the second year of the reign of Darius, king of Persia. Look at verse 5 now. Then the prophets, Haggai, not one, Haggai the prophet, and Zechariah the son of Iddo, prophesied unto the Jews that were in Judah and Jerusalem, in the name of the Lord, in the name of the God of Israel, even unto them. Verse 2 now. Then rose up Zerubbabel, the son of Shealtiel, and Josiah, the son of Jozadak, and began to build the house of God, which is at Jerusalem. And with them, we are the prophets of God, helping them. Something ceased. Something jammed. Something locked. Then arose. They cannot arise if there is no connection. God cannot confirm their prayer in your life if you are mocking them. If you are speaking against them. Then arose the prophets and they prophesied, who confirmed the words of his servants and fulfilled the predictions of his messengers. I remember the testimony of Papa. God told him, meet Adegboye. He will be the one to commission you. He called Adegboye. That said, God said, you are the one that will commission me. Guess what? Adegboye said that I have another assignment. I'm supposed to be on somewhere. When he went to pray, God told him, that assignment is your own. This one is the one I say you should go. He called back Papa. God said, I should be on my way. He said, God has told me too that you are coming. Are you hearing it now? Prophets, they carry transferable unction, impartable grace that can guarantee consistent turn around from shame, from lack, from reproach. Let me make us get the picture clear. How many years have you fasted? How many years have you fasted? How many years have you waited on the Lord? They fasted nothing less than 40, 50 years. So anytime they bless you and impart upon you, they are transferring upon you what has brought them to where they are. And they are giving your life a fast forwarding, a push.
I made go to say this. I had the BOM said, things are not working because I know how to fast or I know how to pray. He said, I'm just riding on the grace of my Father. He said, I know how it works, so I'm just riding on it and it's working for me. Man, the thing is really working. I tell you the truth and I lie not. It's not what they told me, it's what I have been able to hear one-on-one is working. If you are prophetless, you registered yourself for struggle. The ministry of the prophet never leaves any destiny on the same spot. So you either rise by them or you fall by them. You either rise by their ministry or you fall by their ministry. Concerning Jesus, scripture said, he is set today for the rising and for the falling of many in Israel. He is set today for the rising and for the falling of many in Israel. So they are agents to be watched, but dangerous to be mocked. Mocking a prophet, mocking a pastor, mocking a teacher, mocking an evangelist, you are in trouble. 2 Kings chapter 2. Only dummies, spiritual mumus, fight prophets. But I want to let you know, you can't conquer them. Because if truly they are sent, then they didn't come on their own, you will see the hand of God fighting everything around you. Remember the scripture we read some days back? Mordecai said, these are the things that have befallen me. Haman said, these are the things that have befallen me. And the wife Zeri said, if Mordecai be of the seed of the Jew, before whom thou hast begun to fall, he said, thou shalt not prevail against him, but thou shalt surely fall. You don't walk against a prophet and succeed. Look at 2 Kings chapter 2, verse 23. Are you there, studio? And he went up from thence unto Bethel. And as he was going up by the way, there came forth little children out of the city and mocked him and said unto him, go up, thou bow head. Go up, thou bow head. And he turned back and looked on them and cursed them in the name of the Lord. And there came forth two sheep there out of the wood and tore 40 and two children of them. Thou bow head, thou bow head. And he cursed them. I beg you, don't attract a curse from any man of God. What you should crave and desperately seek to get is the blessing they carry. Seek to get the blessing they carry. Some may say, I'm older than him. There are no grace mates. There are only classmates. See them in capacity of sent vessels assigned for your advancement, for your blessings, ordained to take you beyond where you are. Ordained to take you beyond where you are. What are prophets sent to do concerning our destiny and our turnaround? Number one, they are agents of divine help. Just like we read in Ezra chapter 4 and verse 24, down to verse 5, verse 1 and 2. They are helpers of our destiny. They help us to go forward physically, spiritually, mentally. They help us to go forward. They help us to go forward. In 2015, in one of the encounters that I had when I went to visit Ibiomi, I won't forget that day. We got there around 9 o'clock. So he said they should take us to the conference room. We sat down. I went with one of my boys. So we waited and waited. 12, 1, 2, 3. The pastor that followed me now said, "Sir, I'm tired though. I want to go." I said, "If you want to go, I tie your leg. See the door. Please go." I can choose to forego every other thing that I was supposed to do, but let me get this thing. While waiting in the office, in that conference room, I didn't know that there were cameras all around. Even myself, I couldn't see the camera. He was watching me. He said, when he came out, he said, "I was just watching you, watching your countenance. I was reading that book, Holy Spirit, My Helper, written by him." After reading the book, I finished the book while inside that office, inside that conference room. I started speaking in tongues. My pastor will walk outside, come back. He will go down, go drink coke, come back. But I knew that something must answer to me today. So when he came out, he just opened the door. He just laughed at his laugh. He said, "Come." When I entered his office, he said, "I've been watching you from the camera, from my parlor. I was just watching to know whether truly you deserve this oil." From there, he started sharing with me some secrets which I cannot tell you now. After then, he prayed with me. He said, "Maintain this connection." So as we are about to go, he said, "Come back. The Holy Ghost just told me now that I should give you my mantle." He said, "Pastors have been coming here. He has not told me anything like that. He just said I should give you my mantle." I said, "Sir, you hear where, sir?" So immediately, he entered into one, I think that should be his inner chambers. He brought out the mantle. He said, "See this mantle? Keep it. It will answer for you. Everything I've collected from Benny Hinn, Christo Yakilome, Morisello, Matthew Ashimelowo, Bishop Oedekpo, joined together, will answer for you. Who you believe determine the grace you reflect." Who you believe. Hear me? One prophetic contact can end your suffering. I'm the one telling you. Now let me share with you. When I met Pastor Jeme, I knew something. I wanted an aspect of creative ministry. There are people that are in ministry, they look like sufferhead. I'm telling you the truth. But Pastor Jeme is a dynamic, multifaceted, different pastor among the pastors. If you know, you understand what I'm talking about. I was praying, "Lord, I want this thing. I want this creative grace. I want this aspect of him." Why? He is one person that I know that I've served Papa longest one-on-one. Just like Elisha and Gehazi. But Gehazi didn't collect anything. What he collected was leprosy. So I needed this thing. So I was pressing for it, praying, desiring it. One day, say with me, one day. I went, he said, Don't go, sit down. I sat down, I slept off. I was now waiting. And I said, go to the house. I got to the house. He said, go up. I went up. After he talked with me, he brought out one old bottle. The bottle said the thing on the body, written olive oil, the thing on the tear. He brought out the oil. He said, see this oil? May it never finish in your hand. He said, I'm putting in your hand the same rod I collected from Bishop David Oyedepo. It has worked for me. So anywhere you go, anywhere they lie, let them post you. You will shine. The city must hear you. Doors will open for you. Blessings will answer for you. He said, knee down. I knelt down. He prayed with one hand like this. It's like in the spirit, I was seeing the hand enter my head. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? But after that day, say with me, after that day. All round change. All round change. When I mean all round change, all round change. All round change. All round change. Even people around me, even my pastors knew that something has happened. But I didn't want to tell them. Go and get your own. Do you know why I didn't want to tell them? You can't talk about who you believe. Not all of them believe them. I'm telling you the truth. As we are in church now, some people can believe in me. There are people that are on assignment to fight me. But I wish you were. Sit down where. I will grind you like Pepe. I will grind you, grind your nose. Sit under the atmosphere where you can be raised. Hear me? Prophets has the capacity to raise you or to erase you. They are agents of restoration. Isaiah 42 verse 22. But this is a people robbed and spoiled. They are all of them snared in holes and they are hid in prison houses. They are for a prey and none deliver it. For a spoil and none saith restore. What happened to the widow of Zarephath? What happened to the Shunammite woman? I perceive this is a man of God. I perceive. The man didn't tell him, I perceive. So what he carried followed him. Shunammite woman said, this is just a little oil that we will eat. And tomorrow we do what? Die. He said, no, go gather vessels. Gather more vessels. I want you to hear this. The prophet you believe determines your promotion. Determines the flow of financial blessings in your life. I remember one deacon. He's not a pastor. I love him so much. Engineer Delike is his name. He understands what we are talking about. So blessed. So blessed. When I mean blessed, blessed, blessed. He understands prophetic connection and blessings. 3 years back, he said, pastor, any job that is below 30 million now, don't collect again. I just dash it to my boys. I said, what did you say? He said, yes, sir. Any job that is below 30 million, I don't collect again. I dash it to my boys. And he has boys, plenty boys, working with him. He's a civil engineer. Now his pattern is, he will start the building, you pay him 50% upfront, he finish the job, you pay the balance. It doesn't work for small people again. Before he works for you, you must have big money. Now, he's still a Sunday school teacher in Teens Church. He never misses foundation class. He teaches in foundation class. But if you see him, he'll be like this, brother. Stand up, may they see you. That's what he did. Sit down. Now, so you go get money like I'm on. I say, now, so you go get money like her. So blessed, so blessed. He was so blessed that when he built his house, they used 6 million, they plant flower. It's not how. Is it too much? It's not too much. God will bless you like that. They are agents of restoration. So God can use them to bring you out of financial shame. They are also agents of breakthrough. Hear me, that word breakthrough responds to something, the word of blessing. The word blessing is a spiritual force released to compel things to work in your favor. The word curses is a spiritual force that compels demonic agents, giving them a mandate to work havoc in your life. We get the graphical picture of the blessing in Genesis 27. Reading down from verse 27. When Jacob was blessed, he collected the blessing of his brother Esau. His father said, I have blessed him, and indeed he shall be blessed. I have blessed him, and he shall be blessed. Did the blessing come to pass or not? Esau cried out, my father, don't you have one blessing for me? Bless me also, my father. Even so, one blessing. The same blessing he poured upon Jacob is the same blessing. When you go back, read it, there's no time again. He poured the same thing upon Esau, but he gave him one condition. He said, you will only succeed in breaking his yoke after you have prayed your way through. And Esau did. After he did, Jacob was coming to visit him. He carried a bag of groundnuts, bags of corn, bags of rice, bag of beans. Say, man, I go meet him first. When he see food, he go change his mind. Now food, now use deceive him. Carry food, go meet him. Carry food, go meet him. So when they met Jacob, Esau, our God say, man, will give you food. Say, keep your food. I am blessed. I have enough. You can share it to the amajiris around. Say, keep your food. I am blessed. When he came, he thought he was going to kill him. He said, no, God has blessed me. That thing you thought you collected from me, God has put it upon me. Hear me and hear me well. I stand to speak for someone. What they collected from you, I put it back upon your life. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Amen. But before this blessing must work, you must receive the prophet sent to you. Scripture says, believe the Lord thy God and thou shalt be established. Believe also his prophets, so shalt thou prosper. So my prosperity is in their hand. Let me tell you this before I will rise up to pray. How did I get in contact with Apostle Suleiman? I was in a dream, in a meeting where he was preaching. So he was imparting people. He got to where I was. He said, you come out here. He finished imparting. He said, lie down. I lie down, face up. He laid on me and he like, ah. I said, so the thing is burning me. He said, you need this fire. You need this fire. It is again. Ah! I was struggling. I woke up. I was sweating. I told myself, I think I need to meet him. So one day, just went for one of their, what do they call it? That their last Saturday? Fire night. Just went for their fire night. I packaged the seed, two different seeds. The first one was 100K. I dropped that one. So, he now came. He said, we should line up. When he prayed for me, it's like, you know this plane? That's their propeller. They use blow me, go where this man, cameraman stay. One impartation threw away me. They catch me, bring me back. He said, bring him. He did another one. Tom! He said, bring him again. He did the third one. The pastor just waged me. I asked him, what happened? He said, he just fall. It was a funny thing. Really funny, but I knew something entered. Who I know that I need, I connect to them. If I must reach where God has a mind for me, there is something I must collect from them. What you actually do in essence is connecting to their grace so that your destiny can be advanced. It's not a one-time connection. It's a consistent connection. I will talk about Bishop Abiye another day. But every month, I go for impartation. Because I know, apart from his wife, he's the second principal recipient of every grace upon Bishop David Olaniyi Oyedepo. Am I saying the truth? Principal recipient. So as the thing is working for him, it's working on this head. Rise up to your feet. I've used these pictures to make you understand that you are not permitted to crawl again. They asked the question, is Saul also among the prophets? As soon as he prophesied, he went up onto his high places. You can't connect to prophetic grace and be doing meke-meke on the road. Your destiny must be fast-forwarded. You are going to pray, Lord, whatever has made Oyedepo, whatever has made this ministry what it is, I believe in your servant. Let my story change. On this ground of signs and wonders, on this ground of prosperity, on this ground of liberation, let the grace that is at work in this place affect my change of story. Lift up your voice and pray from the depth of your heart. Pray from the depth of your heart. Leko shito zan inkato zezila. Jekute be isotetola. Reklato za itetene jetusiate. Belo shi useto akleketu zezozia. Je osa ikle etopre denusha. Je kotari halo shetonande. Je sozikle kete. Ri dola shekuta rekote kete. Je kote li kete preketo zizozo. Lampola andikudu jenozizu. Je kote te rika kote prekete sozizezia. Li angete kete kete zuzu. Je kote te ri haleta. Alle kledu sate le boro shikata. Reto blaba shato le zezia ba. Ranzenandre di isodono rekute. La poradia esese nekete. Lord, my struggle must come to an end. Stagnation must come to an end. Frustration must come to an end. La rodo shiku setelia. Reza sakleke to breketeze ziyaba. Lamporedi isonate le tu jada.
Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. All eyes closed. All heads bowed. You are here. You are not born again. You want to make it right with Jesus? Wherever you are, put your right hand on your chest and say this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I come unto you today. I know that I'm a sinner. Forgive me. Wash me with your precious blood. I reject sin. I reject Satan. Come into my life. Be my Lord. Be my Savior. In Jesus' name I pray. If you pray that prayer with me, wherever you are, come now.
I want to know you.
If you're coming, come on. I will anoint you.
I want to see your face.
If you pray that prayer with me, come now. I want to pray with you.